when I finally bit the bullet and told the football coach that I was quitting the football team to join the robotics team, like, he honestly, like, laughed at me. He's like, "You're making a terrible decision." Growing up, I was a huge athlete, played baseball, football. I ran track in high school. I love sports. I still do. But I would say, like, my freshman or my sophomore year of high school, I kind of started to realize that this scrawny kid wasn't going to be a professional football player. Like, I wasn't going to do anything with sports, I guess. It was more of a hobby than it was anything else. And I loved engineering for a while. I had a bunch of friends on the robotics team, and they kind of convinced me, "Hey, you should come try this out." And I fell in love right away. And within a year, I'd gone from a three-sport varsity athlete to a kid that loved robots. When I finally bit the bullet and told the football coach that I was quitting the football team to join the robotics team, like, he honestly, like, laughed at me. He's like, "You're making a terrible decision." When I made that decision in high school, I have to credit my parents to that too, because they recognized that passion and they never let it die. When we had that conversation that I wanted to switch my path over from that love for sports and that love for competitiveness and change that over to robotics, that was a really hard conversation for me. I was a young kid, and they had my back and they told me, like, "You are making the right decision." And the one thing they kept going back to was that I had developed this passion at a young age, and it had kind of taken a backseat to that sports passion for so long, but there was still that passion there. Why not use your love for robotics and engineering and make a life out of that? High school is when I made that realization that I wanted to go into the robotics world and the engineering world. But my first exposure to it was actually at a pretty young age. My third grade teacher, Mrs. Bottiglieri, was telling us all about her week as the lead mentor of the high school robotics team and showing us pictures and videos of their experience at the World Championships. And I was like, "Wow, that's really cool." And once I got into high school, I started a VEX IQ team at my mom's school. And she was actually one of the teachers that was helping out with the team for a while. So it was pretty cool full circle moment that, you know, this was the teacher that kind of gave me that first little exposure to the competitive robotics world. Now, another 10 years later, I was starting my own VEX IQ team with her help. And, you know, obviously her working with my mom now, it's kind of even cooler. They're out at Kelly Elementary School in Southington, Connecticut, teaching the next generation of roboteers. My mom sent me a couple pictures the other day from their library media, and they're teaching VEXGO lessons at her school. So getting that picture from my mom that her and her teachers are using something that I worked on and spent, you know, over a year of time developing with our team here, using that VEXGO system in their classrooms, like, that is the most fulfilling thing in the world.